Hello everyone, my name is Professor Paul Frazier, and today I'm visiting with Brian Scott Sherman, the author of this new inspirational book called Lessons Learned. The book contains 33 incredibly true stories, guaranteed to blow you away. Greetings, Brian.
Hello, Professor. I'm thrilled you enjoy Lessons Learned. Thanks for coming by for a visit.
Oh, my pleasure, Brian. One of the things I enjoyed most about your book is that after each story, you share lessons that you've learned from the experience. I don't recall ever reading a book that was outlined in such an interesting way. I will testify that Lessons Learned is one of those books that's hard to put down once you start reading it. What inspired you to write such a personal book?
I wanted to have something I could pass on to my children, who in turn could pass on to their children and so on. I mean, who wouldn't love to read stories of their great-great-grandparents? I've always enjoyed sharing stories with people, and I cannot tell you how many times I've been told that I should capture some of my stories in a book. So after some extra encouragement from some very trusted friends, that is what I did.
Well, Chapter 5, Falling Off a Mountain, also known as Becoming the Real-Life Clark Griswold, was one of my favorite stories. Filled with a comedy of errors, which resulted in you actually being nicknamed Clark Griswold. Can you explain how this happened?
I was in the very early stages of my military career. Matter of fact, I was still in my teens, and I was sent on a temporary duty assignment to March Air Force Base in California. While there, I became obsessed with the idea of climbing a mountain. I knew it was not safe to climb it alone, but none of my friends wanted to join me. They were having too much fun chasing California girls. I was ready to give up on the idea when out of nowhere I was approached by a military pastor. He introduced himself and asked if everything was okay. When I expressed my desire to climb a mountain, he suggested that we should climb it together. I was so thrilled someone actually wanted to climb it with me that I forgot to bring along some common sense items like food and water. This mistake would set off a trail of errors, which almost ended up costing me my life. Without giving away too much of the story, I will just add that the very next day, while attending church, the pastor, who climbed along with me, introduced me as the real-life Clark Griswold to everyone attending that day. The reaction was so over the top that I decided to keep the new title given to me. And from that point on, I would introduce myself as Brian Scott Sherman, better known as the real-life Clark Griswold. People seem to relish the comparison and puts smiles on people's faces, so it stuck. So much so that I drove around for many years with license plates that read Grizz.
Well, I mentioned that Chapter 5 was my favorite. Which chapter is your favorite, Brian?
All 33 stories are special to me. I mean, it has taken me close to 3.5 years to get to this point. I learned it is much different writing a story than verbally telling one. I put my absolute heart and soul into writing every one of them. So yeah, they're all my favorites.
Nice answer, Brian. And yes, your passion definitely is felt throughout the book. Well, we're sitting here in front of this incredibly beautiful backyard. So let's talk about this place a little bit. You called it the Lagoon, and since it's highlighted in Lessons Learned, I feel like I'm sitting at some high-end resort. I would never leave this place if it were mine. Can you tell me some more about the Lagoon?
Well, first of all, Professor, thanks for the incredible compliment. To me, the ingredients to a perfect day is gathering a family and friends, building a fire on the shore of a body of water, and then sharing stories and laughter. Throw in a couple of appetizers, a few beverages with some music, and presto, great memories are made. The only problem is, how often does a person get to enjoy those special ingredients? I didn't want to wait around for the family vacation or the occasional weekend get-together to enjoy what I love most. So I decided to build it in our backyard so we can enjoy it anytime we want. I absolutely love the outdoors, camping, boating, hiking, fishing, hunting, etc. My wife, Tiffany, on the other hand, is not the biggest fan of the great outdoors. So since she has no desire in joining me on most of my adventures, I thought it would be awesome if I could bring the great outdoors to my backyard so we can enjoy it together.
Well, you've done an exceptional job, and your story entitled Pond Addiction, Size Really Does Matter, is very informative and entertaining. I would recommend anyone considering building a pond to give it a read, because it could end up saving you some time and a lot of money. Lessons Learned is one of those books that pulls on all of your emotions. Well-balanced mix, action, adventure, drama, comedy, romance. Lessons Learned was truly something for everyone. I mean, you survived a head-on car crash into a utility pole, 75 miles per hour, while not wearing your seatbelt. You traveled on your honeymoon in a KC-135 Stratotanker that almost ran off the runway and putting you into the ocean. You came within inches of having your head blown off with a tracer bullet. And of course, the heartbreaking story of a man dying in your arms as his son looked on. Then you have the absolutely comical stories of about having to go through the bathroom while in the Caribbean, to the story that of you accidentally drinking antifreeze. And although that is not necessarily funny, the sequence of events in the hospital were quite hysterical. Speaking of hysterical, the story of you pulling your grandma's dentures out of a pile of puke on the side of the highway, my stomach was in knots. Finally, it's romance a person craves. Lessons Learned will also fill that hunger. You have some romantic stories of you finding love again, and it had me wanting to be young. Was it your plan to have such a wide array of emotions in your book?
Well, one of the people I worked with while writing Lessons Learned was the very talented Brian Thomas Schmidt, who, by the way, was recently nominated for a Hugo for his editing work. He helped me select the stories used in the book. We both wanted a wide range of stories that would hopefully appeal to a large audience.
Well, mission accomplished. Thanking you for allowing me this opportunity to sit down with you today and discuss your book, Lessons Learned.
You're more than welcome, Professor. We'll have to have you back in the spring when most of the flowers are in full bloom, instead of now, where everything has been cut back for the winter.
Sounds great, Brian. If you're interested in a great read from Lessons Learned, it should be on your list. It'll be available on Amazon in December. I highly recommend you ordering it when it's available, and I'm certain you will not be disappointed.
Some things that I regret, some words I wish had gone unsaid, some starts that had some better endings, been some bad times I've been through, damage I cannot undo, some things I wish I could do all over again, but it don't really matter when life gets that much harder, it makes you that much stronger. Some pages turned, some bridges burned, but there were lessons learned. From every tear that had to fall from my eyes, from every day I wondered how I'd get through the night. Every change life has thrown me, I'm thankful for every break. Should have taken, been some signs I didn't see, hearts that I hurt needlessly, some wounds that I wish I could have one more chance.